How much air pressure does it take to inflate a balloon? What about burst it? I wanted to find out. I also wanted a good excuse to buy a comically large pressure gauge. But since I didn't yet know the answer to my question, it made it hard to properly size a gauge, like choose its range. Answers online were all over the place, some that clearly didn't make any sense. The last thing I wanted to do was buy a super expensive oversized pressure gauge and have the needle barely move. So I figured I could use some deductive reasoning. I know I can inflate a balloon by breath and even burst it. Therefore, a balloon must have a similar pressure to the strength of a breath. Data on breath strength wasn't super consistent either, but at least the data seemed plausible. I imagine it is something that varies person to person, like height. Supposedly, a person can blow with a pressure between 0.5 and 2.5 psi. Well, $160 later, I have a giant pressure gauge that very accurately reads off values from 0 to 3 psi. A trip to the hardware store and another $50 in pipe fittings, and I have a nice little stand. Let's see what this will do. To start, I test my breath theory. It seems I can blow with about 2.8 psi of pressure. Wow, if the internet is anything to go by, I think I just broke a world record. But I am glad I went with the 3 psi gauge and not the 2 psi one. Hey, while I'm at it, I wonder what some of my pumps can deliver. Wow, this one sucks. Well, I mean blows. Just not very well. This one is better. Loud as all heck, though. Here is my MetroVac pump. It claims 4 psi on the datasheet. Nice. It looks like it's telling the truth. I can't turn it all the way up because I don't want to break my pressure gauge. Alright, enough messing around. Let's inflate a balloon already. It is interesting to see the initial spike in pressure needed to get the balloon stretching. This probably explains why it can sometimes be hard to get the balloon started, and why manufacturers often recommend hand stretching the balloon before inflation. The pressure appears to stay constant while the balloon is spherical. However, the pressure begins to increase as the balloon turns pear-shaped. It is clearly full around 1 psi, where the neck of the balloon begins to inflate substantially. The balloon makes it a little past 1.3 psi before it bursts. I hope my video has piqued your interest. Let me know what you think. I didn't buy that pressure gauge for just one video. Should I test a bunch of balloon brands, different colors, sizes, inflatables? Leave a comment below and don't forget to subscribe and like the video. If you'd like to support my channel, you can buy a t-shirt from the link in the description. Thanks for watching.